Well, folks, I'm here at Pondwood Fishery. Got a variety of lakes, day ticket water, just a regular day ticket water. It is in the, I'm going to call it, realms of being a bit of a heat stroke at the moment. Heat's very, very hot, which is nice, but not so good for the fishing, is it? Not so great for fishing. I've seen a few fish move off the top. I'm here looking for catfish, but I'm going to be using a totally different bait. They've got a sort of island peninsula bit there with a bridge that you can fish over there. But Josh tells me a lot of the fish are close in around the margins. The cats, maybe they cruise around the edge. And I've picked this side here, because look, blue sky, there's trees. There is at least a little bit of shade for me here. And one assumes for the fish as well. And I have seen a few small, medium carp just lazing in the sunshine. I've not had any yet. You can use bread here. It's a time that I'm filming. You can use floating crust and stuff. It's going to be noisy because we're right over a flight path, and there is indeed a small airfield here as well for light aircraft. As you can see, there's lots of early sort of, going to call them autumn leaves, dried leaves on the surface there. I'll probably rig up as well my Avon rod, but with a waggler float. They give me a bit of extra casting weight out there, and send out a floating crust and see if I can't pick a carp off the surface as a bonus. But you guys want to know what this weird bait is, don't you? I know, you can't keep anything from you. It's a first for me, because I have never caught a catfish using a piece of Barracuda. Now, apparently they've been getting the odd catfish on mackerel chunked up here. So let's get one of these guys cut up. They look like European Barracuda. And let's see if we can get a catfish on a Barracuda. I'll be surprised, I must admit. Gonna seem more like I'm sea fishing doing this. Let's cut one of these off. Fish that have been donated by one of our supporters and his dad. So, I'm going to cut that into about four. No, make that six. Make that five. Right, rag. I don't exactly know what they... Can't smell them. I'm smelling them, but they got the guts and that in them, so we'll see what we can get out there. I just got one treble A shot on, so sort of balance the bait on the bottom, just hold it in position. So yeah, no, it must be to get like a drop back bite there. I'm going to use a middle section here. I'm just going to go through the bottom of the guts here. Oh, plenty of juice coming out of them. Yeah, planes are, oh yeah, they do smell. I've got it in my hand now. Take a bit of scrap fishing line off my reel, pull it through, like this. Just gonna make a little hair rig of it. Just out we go there. I feel these leaves are going to be a problem on the line as well. So I'm fishing straight up with the reel, probably on backwind. Very light bobbing. That's just there. That one seemed to work with the bread round it. Right, the trap is set. I've got some bits of bread left over. And I'll rig up the Avon rod. Let's see if we can't get anything feeding off the top. I guess there's going to be nothing feeding until perhaps evening, I'm going to say. 5 o'clock, this could be either a blank or a one fish deal. Well, it is looking like following on from the blank I had down at Hailing Beach. It looks like it's another blank session. I cannot get the carp going on the top. It's obviously very, very warm. Josh just came around the owner and said that it might switch on in the evening. I've seen catfish caught on the point. Not big ones. I've seen catfish caught there, not big ones, but they caught right by the rushes. There were two sort of pre-booked swims, the guys were there early, I guess. But, you know, who knows where they could be. I previously caught on this bank, I previously caught up there. I'm trying now change to float fishing out there, because the guy who was catching over there caught on float, just suspended a piece of mackerel. So I've got one round there by that tree stump. Still contemplating whether I leave it onto the float, but you know, I've seen them caught on the float. I've seen them caught just ledgering up against those rushes over there, so who knows. This generally been quite a good corner, but I throw the bread out and just these little fry dimpling here, they're the only ones that's taking the bread. I see the occasional swirl from a better carp, but they are definitely not on the go for it. And what happens is the little fish, you think they're not taking it, they're knocking it around, they're actually nibbling it away, little piranhas. So once it goes still and smooth, you know they've got the bread, it's gone. You can see fish moving over there. All small stuff, no real bubbling, nothing going on. But you never know. I'm going to give it probably till 7 o'clock and I might call it quits. Do you go trout fishing with Mike? Goodness me, it's going to be tough trout fishing tomorrow. I hope we can catch fish. I have to go earlier in the morning, I feel. I mean, it is absolutely fabulous weather. Look at it. Absolutely beautiful weather. But it can be tough, it can make it very, very tough. And that's what I'm finding at the moment. See, small fish moving down here. We're looking at a one fish wonder, guys. The other guys are on mackerel, I am on the barracuda. I cannot see them not liking a piece of barracuda, but I've got to find a cat. Oh, I had a knock on the float then. I've got to find a catfish, you know, and put it in front of a catfish versus. Every time you use a new bait, it's always a little bit nerve-wracking, you know, because you think, oh, I've normally caught on this method or that method. But you have to experiment, you have to go through the blanks. That's how people know what the best baits are, because presumably they've been through other baits blanking and then eventually find a good one. If not, we're going to have to take this barracuda out to sea where it came from and hopefully catch a fish, sea fish on it. If I stand up, you probably see all the small fish piling into the bed down there. I mean, they spooked, so I stood up just down in here. That's a better fish there. But I'm kind of wondering, normally I would say that bread being knocked around by the small fish would attract the carp. It doesn't appear that it is. I know, I saw a guy catch 7 right down there once. I mean, literally down there. I was fishing in the next swim here and his rod just kept getting wrenched right around there and he was right under there. I will put one there in a minute, but I've got one over by the tree at the moment. And I wonder if I put, look, they've nearly eaten all that bread. Sort of hard to believe, really. I'm just looking around here, next thing I know, the rod is like this, the bait runner's pouring out. I lift into it, get up a tree here, can't really load up on a catfish, hook a catfish, play it for a little while, and then get the bait back. Just didn't set up on it, it's too far away for me to set the hook. My fault for going, well, I sort of set myself up under this tree as it is. Ah, I don't know what to say. All these hours sitting for nothing. I've moved. Throwing the floats out, messing around here, having a sandwich or something. Next thing I know, the rod's doing this. Bait runner's pouring out. I lift up, get caught up in the tree up there, so I can't tighten on the fish. When I do tighten on the fish, 2 or 3 heavy pulls, hook pulls back. I just couldn't set up on the fish. So they will take barracuda. I'm one step closer to catching a fish on barracuda. There's nothing coming up here on the small baits. They're just basically demolishing all the bread. No carp coming up or anything, you just see them dimpling away there on the surface. So it's just a question of waiting for a couple of hours, see if I can luck out on one. Finally. A waggler float, a piece of sunk breadflake in amongst all those fry has got me hooked up. Who knows, the way it's gone today, it's gonna fall off. I'll settle for one carp of any size, 0.5 pound upwards. Don't think he's a very big fish. But I've got nothing off the surface, so I put the... He's pulling pretty hard for a carp. I thought it was about a 3-pound carp. Hang on a minute. I've gone quiet. Sort of a uncarpy-like fight, if that means anything to you. That's a twangy old fight. I'm not sure this is a carp. What is this? Probably is. There's a 757 going to Dubai up there. Good luck. Won't be going on one of those for some time. Well, this fish is going very well. I'm not going to mess with the camera. I'm going to get what I get, planes or no planes. I've only got 30 minutes left. Hey, Josh, should they shut about 7? It's a funny old fight. What is that? Is that... Oh, my God. That was a funny tail, I've got to say. Hang on a minute, boys. Hang on. That boil swirl there, that makes me think it's... I'm not even going to use the word. I'm not going to use the word. If he gets me in the side, I'm done for. Oh, no, come on. Just come out of this with a fish, please. It's definitely, it's a catfish. Holy smokes, breadflake. A piece of breadflake. It's a catfish, all right. It's not a bad one for an avian rod. Come on, baby, don't fall off that. Come on, come on. My arms aren't long enough. Tell me to take a swim backwards. I think I got him. He won't go in. He's in. Oh, yes. Happy days. Oh, nice catfish. It's on bread. That is hard to believe. It's on a piece of bread flake intended for a 3-pound carp. Let's have a look at you, buddy. Nicked just in the roof of the mouth there. There's my setup. A waggler float and just a hook. Look at this. That is a last minute result for me, people. Well done, Graham. He knew he was going to catch that. He's supposed to be taking my barracuda bait. And that's a decent one. There we go, guys. Hope he doesn't wiggle. He's going to wiggle. Isn't it annoying? Isn't it annoying? You just want a few seconds. I'm on my knees. There we go. Well, people, well, I'm not even going to say I deserve that. Really, really. I sort of do deserve it. You know I do. You're a fisherman out there. I really did deserve that. I've lost that other one. Moved swims. Tried everything. One fish lost on the barracuda and one fish on an antenna float, size 10 hook, and a piece of bread flake sunk 2 feet down off the bottom. It doesn't make sense, but it's gratefully accepted, I can assure you. I think I get the last of that bread in. So that sort of makes me wonder if you keep throwing all that bread out, all those small fish. I was there. Well, you might, I don't, you won't see it with this camera. The bread's down there on the surface, all the little fish are nibbling away, and I wonder if that catfish came in and just saw about 2 feet down the bread suspended there. But honest to God, I thought it was a carp. Some of those weird little takes on the surface, they might not actually be carp. I wonder if they are catfish. Because they look like a 2 or 3 pound, like dimple just on the... Oh, see what I mean? I missed it. I think I'm gonna have to concentrate for a second, guys. I'll try and stand up. My float is there, the antenna float just there. The bread's on the surface. See, there's a fish moved to the top. I wonder if they're catfish. I just missed that last bite. So I'm just going to sit there with the float in amongst all the... See, those fish just splintered there then. Wow, they could drive you to distraction being under the flight path. Every now and then those fish splinter, whereas though they're feeding on the bread, something moves in the area. It could be a carp, of course. Bigger carp will push them out. But I wonder if it's a catfish and they just spook. Anyway, fish just moved in there too. So the one here is straight out there with the barracuda meat on it. And the bread is in here. Do you know, I've got a feeling that bread's going to go again. On again, guys. I've got to keep it under my... I think it's another catfish. I really do. I've seen strange mouths coming up taking bread off the top. And I've got a feeling it might be another catfish. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's a carp this time. Got it the other way around. One looks a big fish. This one's not. Pretty sure it's a catfish. I put a bigger piece of crust on. Just left it isolated and all the fry literally scattered. They were nibbling at it and then they scattered. Meanwhile, the fish bait remains untouched. This is definitely, I feel, another cat. You can see the waggler float there. These slim wagglers are really good. Fish take that, they don't even know they've got it. Give you a good bite indication. There's a lot of swirling going on here and a lot of bent rod. Yeah, it's got to be a cat. Just too much power for a carp. Wow, they got some. It's just holding that rod, look. It's just holding it totally buckled over. Am I going to get lucky? I've gone all quiet again. Every time Graham goes quiet, you know something's going to happen. It's when his nerves are going. Trouble is, they got an abrasive sort of lip to them, and I've got to be honest, I didn't check that hook link from the last fish. It could have chafed it. So it's kind of stupid of me. I should have just snipped that, reset, tied on. Yeah, it's got to be a carp. Oh, it's got to be a catfish, this one. Surely. It's a carp on steroids. It's a carp on steroids. How wrong can you get? Nice carp too, chunky one. Oh yeah. Oh yes. That is not a million miles away from a double figure fish. Just nick that, hooks out. He's going to be awfully close to 10. Let's give him an easy £9 to be honest and be grateful. Wow, result. I've loaded up again, guys. Just literally there float fishing. This waggler is doing the biz. I cannot believe I thought I was on a total blank. I really seriously did. Stilled off. What's happened is a weather system coming. I was supposed to be going trout fishing tomorrow with Mike. We were going boat fishing. They've both been cancelled both days. This feels a heavy fish. Now, that's more carpy. Yeah, but what's happened is the wind's gone round and it's pushing the rubbish up this way. So it gives me a lovely clear spot to float fish there. And the light is perfect at the moment. I'm not going to mess around. If I get a chance, I'm going to take it. I don't know whether this is a carp or a catfish. I can't call any more fish like this now. Whatever it is, I'll get it round the wrong way. I've got it down as a carp. That was sunk breadflake. Oh, he's petering me out now. Yeah, it's more like a carp run. Don't go around my other line. Oh no, he's going all twangy on me. What is that? I still can't see him going. I still cannot see him. I've got quite a bit of pressure on the rod. Stirring all the mud up on the bottom, so I'm going to call it a cat. See if I'm right. I saw a mouth. I think it is a cat. He stirred all the bottom up. Breadflake again. I don't get it. It's a strange old game, this catfish, isn't it? Smaller than the other ones. Lucky to get the other one in. Well, two cats and a carp. Happy days, that will do me. The hook's out. There he is. I don't know where he goes. £5. What a session. Thanks for staying with us, guys. And you knew I was always into the chance. I didn't. I thought I was stuffed. Let's get him back. Quite a biggish gob of bread. I've thrown the last of my crust out. I wet it once so it sinks. I flick it into the middle of where the little fish are. Drag set. I tighten up, just hold it across my fingers as well. So if I'm looking over here, look, it's a fish just moved from there. See the ripples going? I've got 5 minute warning on here, people. In fact, I should have got packed up 10 minutes ago, but Josh said he's going to play around a golf, so he won't lock up for another 20 minutes, half hour. So I'm not one to look a gift horse in the mouth. Oh, Christ, I'm on. Look at this kitty go. Oh my God, I think he's hooked in the ear. Or the wedding tackle. This one's going to bust me, I should say. Look where he's going. It's got to be foul hooked, hasn't it? Got to be. I don't know, it's about 40 pounds. Oh my God, I haven't got a turn on it. It's going right at the other side of the lake. He's going to be in the rushes in a minute. That has to be smack of a foul hook fish. So I guess this is a one-way ticket. A foul hook catfish. Happy days. I think I'll see you guys next Easter. I've got the rod flat to get maximum power. That was bizarre. Hopefully you got it all on camera, even if I lose it. What a walloping take that was. Now, I'm going to keep the rod a bit higher. I think he might have burnt out. Oh no, perhaps. Why did I say that? The way that one took off, there's no way in the world I think that's hooked normally. He's 50 yards away, I should think. He's just off the M4. Just got to get conditions right, isn't it? Just look at it. It's beautiful for float fishing. Absolutely superb. Nah, that's got to be a foul hook big fish. I'm losing again. He's going to go round that island into the next lake. That's as much as I can give it without busting off. It's going to bust off anyway, I dare say, but I'll give it my best shot. I suppose a point to work in my favour would be it's hot. So there's low oxygen content, I guess, in the water, so he might tire out. I'm going to bring this off for a second, guys. I've got the other rod in. That's out of the way. So I'm done now, whatever I do. If it busts off, I'm done. Home time. I'd just like to see it, but let's see how far we get. Ah. I can't even stand up for this one. The boiling swell tells me it's a foul hook catfish into the tail. Would I get lucky? Pretty sure it's a foul hook cat. Look at the size of that swirl out there. I'm going to try and keep the rod low. So I want most of the pressure under the water, not jerking around on the surface. Still feels a heavy fish, even if it's coming in backwards. Could be a carp coming in sideways, I suppose. Could be a roach coming in upside down. A spur dog coming in inside out. I've got it down as a cat, though. It's not indeed, it is a carp. It's 100% got to be foul hook, though. We've still got to get lucky to get this fish in. This is when you can break a rod, so be careful, or right in the tail. Go on, back one as well. Look at that. Could have sworn, first it's a catfish, and it's this, and it's that. It's a carp. Well, there you go. People, two carp. And two cats from absolutely nothing all afternoon. That's about another 9. Might go 10. I couldn't have hooked that more in a tail if I wanted to. No wonder he cranked off. Where was he? Oh, he's hooked in the orifice. Well, you would fight pretty hard, wouldn't you, if you were hooked in the keister. Even got his fin up for you, people. Brilliant. Great session. Straight back. I must pack up now. Thanks for staying with me. Two carp, two catfish. We'll see you on the next show. I just hope I don't leave it as late as this one.
But listen, there's something else I wanted to talk about. Mike hasn't really seen this yet. If you follow us for the last 10 years, you might have remembered the totally awesome fishing office here. And just there, I had the pool table, which I've never really used a great deal except with family and stuff and special events. Christmas, that sort of time we have people around. I use it as a workbench, and that's wrong. So there is now this, a very huge hole in our room, together with big squares on the carpet where it went. Yes, folks, it's true. The totally awesome pool table is no more. It has been sold, which reminds me, I've got a high sea drifter outside. I've got it all tarped up, all ready to go. I've got to put it up and advertise it. It's got to go. I've got to sell it. Someone's going to get a bargain because I'm getting rid of everything. Okay, so what's happened here? I'll show you what's happened here. I turned the camera around. The big void where the pool table went is now the new photographic studio. And it's all been turned around. I have a new pine table there. And ta-da! There we have. Yes, exactly. The new film area for me. So, moved everything around. But now, looking down here, on the table you will notice a fly fishing waistcoat, some fly fishing reels, a net, fly fishing hat, and yes, polarizing glasses, which means that's correct. Following on from that catfish and carp expedition at Pomwood, I'm gonna take you guys fishing yet again in the same film episode. Yes, we're going to be going trout fishing. I'm going to try and catch a big trout this time. So I'm not going to be casting at all the small ones, say 3-4 pounds, something like that. I'm aiming for something that is a big chunk. The place I'm going to is Deaver Springs. I've already rigged my 2 fly rods up, which I generally do in the morning in the car. Not in the car, but you know, when I arrive at the fishery. By which times, I'm so excited, my hands are shaking, I can't tie the leader knots and the fly knots. So I thought, you know what, Graham? Do it in the new, totally awesome film studio. So I've got my flies, I've got the old Sid Knight, I think it was late Sid Knight, Pearly Daddies, and a variation one called a Glister, I think it is. I'm going to give those a go, but listen, guys, it's late summer. It's low water, it's weedy. It's hard fishing, I know it's hard fishing, but something tells me I've got to give it a go. I'm not looking to fill up a trailer with trout, I'm looking to catch maybe one, if I'm very lucky, 2 trout. I've no idea what it's fishing like, I haven't been there for, a couple of years, 18 months, 1.5 years, long time anyway. So time for some trout fishing, join me in the car, let's get down to Deaver Springs, one of the great trout fishing waters in the south, in Hampshire, my home county, and see if we can't hook something up for you people. Browns, rainbows, blues, I'm not fussy, a trout will be handy. Well, there you go, people. Hopefully a bit of interest in this episode, a sort of double bill for you. And I love here, I put some click flooring down here because I couldn't roll the wheels of the office chair on the carpet. And now, I can. It's lovely, and it was free. It was going in a skip in one of the big carpet shops. And they said, yeah, take it, mate. Nobody's going to use it. I must have put it in about 5 flats now. I had like half a pallet load of it.
So I've got clink floor in there, table here. I'll tell you what I will do, and what I do need, is a black screen. I'm going to get a piece of board and paint it matte black. No doubt the copiers will copy, but I think everything in the small close-up range of tackle will come out better matte black. But I'm well pleased with the new Totally Awesome studio here. Hopefully we'll find some interesting things to talk about, and fingers crossed we get some fish for you guys.
So this is a type of boat they use for trimming the weed here at Deve, as you can see. It's got a big propeller. Well, I think I could do with that on my boat when I used to go fishing with it. It's like a sort of corkscrew effect there. I'm wondering if that actually chops up the weed as well. I don't know. I must ask Jamie or Stuart with that. So it looks like a chopper to me as well. This is the first time I've seen the boat that's actually out of the water. A side-on steering wheel by the look of it there. I don't know what that does. Maybe it's not the steering wheel. Must be for directional. And then different cutting teeth here at the top, you can see. Quite interesting. Bit of shark cable there that I would use shark fishing. And cutting teeth there, and I imagine they sharpen all the blades. And they crisscross backwards and forwards. I think we have got a film up with Stuart doing the weed here. It's going to be breezy, it's going to be tough. I'm going to go down and have a look, see how low the river is as well. That's the other thing they've got to do is they have to manually get the weed out. People don't realise how much work's involved. So I guess they use these nets here to manually drag all that weed out, keep it clear, because there's nothing worse for fly fishing than having your leader snag up and you can't actually get a fly down to the fish. I always like to have a little look in these corners as well, because you never know where you're going to spot a fish. So they also got to keep aeration going on the stock ponds and different stews. Actually, what's the difference between a stew and a stock pond? Are the stews these ones? But this has got fish in it because it's got the blower going. Over here you've got a stretch of river. Wow, that breeze is strong. And they transport the fish from the stock ponds are holding or feeding on ponds using these tanks. They're moving fish around, and you can see they've got the air tanks there to blow in. And there's the river, which doesn't look too bad considering we've had drought conditions. It looks very tidy. Oh, there's a trout and a grayling. Just on that patch there. I don't know if you guys will see it. It's 3-4 fish there. They're only small. But you can see. I think you can still always check, but I think you can still fish the river here as well separately. I'll hold it out there, you can see up the river more. You want something like a real light 4-weight. You can even go down to a real mini stick, like a 2-weight if you wanted to have a bit of fun. You don't need a big long rod because there's trees overhanging here as well. So I like to take a bit of time just to walk around first. Even with this wind, I might find a clear patch or indeed an individual fish, you know, that I can spot. And that's what I'm looking for, shapes, colours in the water. And I find if you're looking for a trout on the water, it's a sort of purpley. I think that's a bacon sandwiches are done. Just taking a look down this side, I still can't see any fish with this ripple on the water. Let's have a walk down the smaller lake, I think. Did see one fish roll between those bushes. It's about the only place I've got of maybe seeing a fish there. My goodness, it's tough. Oh, I see one. Okay, I'm going to drop the net. Obviously, no idea it's going to take. He's laying. I'll come in as close as I can because I've got polarizing glass so I can see it. He's laying just down there. And that's quite a big fish. That's the other side of 5 pounds. Now that's interesting. And you can see what I mean about it. Just pays you just to walk around and have a look. That flow comes across here and there's a fish laying in this area. Very, very tough seeing fish today. Might have to do some what they call blind casting, where you just cast it out and strip him back. All right, and of course you've got the shadow line here from the trees, which is handy. And very often you'll get a decent fish laying around in the shadow of the trees as well. Check everything if you get the chance. I can always cast, right hand is sending the line this way through that gap, even with this wind. He doesn't seem interested at all. And I can't quite see the distance a fly is from the trout's nose. There is a real big one down there, people. Very, very big fish. Just down in the corner, but I can't see it. You know, the reaction to the fly. It's absolutely howling now. I'm going to have to try, I think, a long cast. Now, I don't stand there, I stand down here, so my rod top's over there. I might be able to push a fly line out through that way. Obviously, I might lose a fly as well. I'm thinking, I've seen a couple of fish roll out there. If I get a long enough line out, I might actually be able to be in with a chance. Oh, there's a fish that's moved there. Right, more hopeful now. I think I might have made a rash decision about coming on such a windy day. Just got to get that back cast right. I think we could actually go further. There's a fish move there. You see that smooth spot in amongst the ripple? Possibly a faster sink fly. I'll try a fast strip. Guys, it's not the big one, but it's a pretty good fish anyway. That's in close, so we'll see if we can get this one in. I'm on again, boys, but that was a blind fish. I couldn't see it. It took on the drop. I've got a feeling it's a smaller one. Let's get the net. What a shame that other fish came off. That was a good one. Listen, we're going to come out of this with a trout. Oh, I was looking for big ones. This one's took on the drop. Still quite a bit of weed there. I've got to be careful you don't get in the weed. That's where you might go. Over the 4 pounds. He's going for the weed. Now he's going out again. Closer, closer, ever closer. That's my extended net.
enough. Come on. Here he comes. I think he's done. Yeah. And he's in. Poo big ray. Can't beat a bit of fly fishing, can you? Mix it all up. I like mixed fishing. I've moved right round to up from that swim and got a regular stocky hooked up. Pinged off. It's gone really tough, guys. I'm fishing away, as you can see, in the middle of the main lake here, and I just happened to look down here and there's a trout right under my feet. I mean, I don't know whether you're going to see him there. He's almost too close to cast. Look, I've got to put the leader in the rod ring and sort of lower it. I can see him, I can't quite see his head there, so I'm going to have to watch his mouth. Oh, that looks a better, that's a better angle. I'm just quivering the fly. Right in front of his nose. I'm virtually under the rod. Well, I am under the rod, I don't know how I'm going to get that close. So I can move the weed with my rod top, but I fear I'm going to spook the fish. That is strange. I'm just a little bit too much weed there. That fish has come right back to the same spot. That big one, I'm going to have another dabble at it. Got a bigger fish on this time, people. Just came back around the edge here. Back to the same spot I was filming this morning. Try and work him around this side a bit. See if we can get around this side.
Happy with that?
Nah, it'd be fine, yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Make it more exciting. So there's two fish there, and this one just came up and snapped at it. It's not the big one, but it is probably about the size I'm looking for. A 5-pluser. I need to sit down or lay down. Wow, this has been a tough one. Here he comes, come on. No, he's not done. Wow, I think I'd be lucky if I get this one out. I don't want to shorten up anymore and get the leader knot jammed in the tip ring. Here he comes, just hooked in the top.
we got him. Oh, he's out. There's a hole in the net there, Pete. The fish went in, out the other side of the net, and the hook's gone, I think. Let's just put him to bye-byes. That's the sort of fish we'd be looking for. That's what you come to deep for, a nice looking fish like that. Wow. Nice big tail. I was lucky it wasn't the giant one I was looking for. But I think that is definitely, for me, fish of the trip. You could make those trout goujons. We got it in our film anyway. One of our films about cooking trout. You can have curry trout. That's really good with fillets of these. But these fish, these two are going to go to the smokers. And they're even better because you haven't got to do anything to them. You just trade them in, pay the extra and get your fish. That is about the best looking silverfish I've had for a long time. And here you might be able to see is the hole in the net that the fish went through. So this net's about 40, 45 years old. Look how many times it's been tied up, that's shocking really. But I'm going to tie that up and I'll still get fish in there. I'm not buying a new one. Might find a nice second hand one though. Well, certainly pleased with that fish, guys. This is like the only pocket that I can see some of. The big fish is a really big fish. I mean a really, really big fish. It's probably double figures. It keeps coming back in, get its nose there. Other anglers have seen it, they go away. So if I leave this place, I'm not going to get a shot at it. So I fished away here, just what I call blind fishing. Not getting any takes, that's gone dead. Let's get this round. And it's come back. So I'm going to give it a fly, just see if it'll lower it on its nose there. The last one was the smaller of the two that took, and that's a good fish. This one's even bigger, but he's dead twitchy. I'm not surprised, because everybody's having a go at him. So I shall see if I can induce a take. So I'm going to use these trees as a bit of a screen. I'm going to pre-wind my fly to what I think the depth is there. So I just barely want to lower it. I haven't got the greatest glasses. He's about 10 year old, out of date. No, more than that. 18 year old, probably out of date, polarizing prescription glasses. So they're not great. So I've got the fish there. I'm not going to move my arms much. I'm just going to creep in till I can see where I think he is. That's about as far as I'm going to stretch. Generally spook. I'm twitching it somewhere in the right region, I'm thinking. No, he's not having it by the look of it. So he might just snap at it. You guys can see him down. I'm looking for the white flash of mouth, and there's a current coming in there. Well, I think we're going to call it, guys. The bigger fish is coming. I can't catch him anyway. He's there for, as we say, another day. I don't even know if I got that hook up of larger of the two I got. I'm not even sure. Good. I've done it so many times, messed about the camera trying to get you guys some action and pressed off instead of on. So I'm going to go back, weigh these fish, and see if I have in fact beaten the 4 pound size. So we're back in the weigh scales, just see what we've got. I'm thinking this one's going to over 4. I think 4 and a quarter. Let's get it in. Oh goodness, you wouldn't play poker against me, would you? It's like about 4-6. Must put this guy over 5, I'm gonna say. 5 and a quarter. Whoa, look, where's a quarter? Guy sensitive there. 5 pound 2, straight that way. So 5 pound 2. That's a really good little session, albeit it was hard, but you know, afternoon fishing a diver, it's always worth a go. Wind's coming up again, it's getting pretty black over there. You can see over the back here. Most of the anglers, I think, are packed up now, so fingers crossed. We'll see you back at the office.
Thanks for watching the Totally Awesome Fishing Show. I've got to think what I'm going to put in this void over here. I've got a picture there. I had a 450-pound sawfish there. What can I put around it that sort of equates to that sort of monumental prehistoric type fish? I remember it, Key West on the Marquesas, or Marquesas as it should be pronounced. I've got a gap there. I've got to find a way of filling that up. Who can plan to find something somewhere? Don't worry. Thanks for watching the Totally Awesome Fishing Show. Hit that subscribe button. Don't forget, go over to Mike's TA Outdoor Show. I've been helping him recently on, well, you got to watch a show to find out. This is, I think it's coming up Friday or Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Almost the same time as this one, where somebody smashed into our famous, our world famous pallet cabin. Now, I built that with my fair hands. Secondhand pallets, bent all the nails out. I know some low-life has smashed in the glass. You need to watch the film to find out. I'd like to find them. Anyway, see you guys in the next episode. And I'm going to find something else to do in the Totally Awesome studio. See you next time.